guys, I welcome you all. How are you guys doing? Good. Okay, I welcome you all in this series of mathematical tools for physics, right? This is me, your Vedantu master teacher, Arvind Sir. I hope the sessions which I have covered under this series so far, you guys enjoyed the session and also got the concepts that I have already discussed, right? I have discussed trigonometry, basic trigonometry, which is required, to excel in understanding the concepts of physics while moving from class 10th to class 11th, right? Okay, so this series is for these people who are moving from class 10th to class 11th, and also for the students who are in higher classes and having difficulties in grasping the concepts of physics just because they don't have much command over these mathematical topics, right? In this series today we'll be discussing the topic areas and volumes of the plane figures and solid geometry. I hope you people find these particular topics very easy, right? So under this series today, let's start with circle, right? Circle, as I've already discussed a bit in session 1 and session 2 as well, right? Let's talk about these two terms, circular arc and circular sector. These topics are very easy, right? But we need to learn these topics because we'll be using these particular things very frequently, right? So if I'm having a circle, right, of radius, let's say some r, right, of some radius r, what will be the area of this circle? Area kitna hoga circle ka? Area will be equal to what? Pi r square, isn't it? Okay, what is the perimeter? Perimeter is 2 pi times of r, that is radius, that is 2 pi r, right? Okay, let's say if I divide this circle in n equal parts like this. Okay, if I divide this circle into n parts, this is one part, this is one part, this is another, this is third, this is fourth, and so on. If I go on like this, let's say I'm having n equal sectors. N equal sectors, why I'm saying this? Because if I split this particular circle into n parts, each having same angle at the center, right? This is something which I'm considering as of now, that if I divide this circle into n parts, each having equal angle at the center, right? So how can I write this particular angle? How can I write this particular angle in terms of n, right? What we did, we divided the whole circle into n parts, that is this whole angle over here, this whole angle over here, which is 360 degree, right? This 360 degree is divided into n equal parts, right? This 360 degree is divided into n equal parts. Let's say I'm taking this angle as x, right? So x will be equal to what? X ka value kitna ho jayega? 360 degree divided over n, right? If I want to write this particular angle in terms of radian, so I can write this 360 degree into radians, that is 2 pi over n, right? Can we find out the angle this way, right? Okay, let's move on to the next thing. If I take the value of n as 2, right? If I take the value of n as 2, that means I am dividing this circle into two parts, right? And that too having equal angles at the center. That means how much angle will that be? Our x in that case would be 180 degree. We'll be having two semicircles, right? If I take n equals to 3, that means I am dividing the circle into 3 equal parts, right? What will be the angle subtended at the center in that case? Right, if this is the circle, right, this is the circle, I'm dividing it into three equal parts, right? What I'm asking, this angle, right? This particular angle, considering all of these angles are equal. So what's that? In that case, x comes out to be 2 pi over 3, or I can say 360 degree over 3, that is equals to 120 degree or 2 pi by 3, right? If I go on like this and divide into multiple parts, like, right? So I'll be having different angles there, right? So I can calculate the angle like this. Now let's discuss about a particular sector. All right, let's discuss about a particular sector. If this is the circle of radius r, right? Radius r. If I'm having this particular sector, let's call this center as O, this point where as B and this point as B, right? So AB is an arc of the circle. AB is an arc. I have told you guys in the first session under mathematical tools, right? There is a relation between this arc length, this radius, and the angle subtended by this arc at the center, right? We have covered this in the first lecture, right? So guys who have already watched those videos will definitely say that arc length is equals to r into theta, or we can say theta is equals to l by r if I'm saying ki arc length is equal to l, right? Theta is equals to L over R. One more thing which I told you guys was that this angle right over here is in radians. We cannot take it in degrees, guys. This is in radians, right? So if I'm having a circular sector, right? If I'm having a circular sector like this, okay, and if this radius r is given to me and this angle is 60 degree, what can I say about this particular arc length? Considering this is a circular arc, what I can say, length is equals to r times theta, and this theta should be in radians, right? So 60 degree is how many radians? Pi by 3. So the length of this arc right over here, AB, in that case will be what? R into pi by 3, that is pi r over 3, right? So we can calculate the arc length like this. Okay, moving on to the next thing, right? We were to discuss about area, right? So we can somebody can ask us that what is the area of this sector, right? Agar koi mujhse puche area of sector OAB kaise nikalenge? कैसे निकालेंगे? We know कि जो पूरा सर्कल है उसका एरिया कितना है? What is the area? Pi r square, पूरे सर्कल का एरिया, right? This pi, if I write this particular same thing as 2 pi into r square over 2, right? 2 pi into r square over 2, right? So what is this 2 pi? 2 pi is the complete angle of the circle, right? Like this, right? In the figure, look at the figure closely. So 2 pi is the complete angle over here, right? So if I want to calculate the area of sector OAB, area of sector OAB, I can write theta in place of 2 pi to get the area of the sector OAB, isn't it? You guys know this much, right? So the area of the sector OAB will be what? Theta into r square over 2, considering that this theta is in radian, number one, and this theta is the angle subtended at the center, right? Right? Achha. Guys who are not able to relate this with this, I would like to explain them in a detailed way, right? Let's say I'm having a semicircle. All right, let's have a semicircle. Okay, now let's have a semicircle, okay, like this. What is the area of this semicircle? Semicircle ka area kitna ho jayega? Considering that it is having a radius r, kitna ho jayega? Pure ka area of the whole circle divided by 2, right? That is pi r square over 2. If I again divide it, right? If I again divide this circle into semicircle into two parts, what I'll get? I'll get area of quadrant of that circle, area of quadrant of that circle, isn't it? What will be that? That will be again half of this, half of the area of semicircle, or I can say 1/4 of the area of circle, isn't it? So that will be equal to pi r square over 4, and so on. If we go, so we can see a trend that we have that I have just used in the last slide, right over here. So the area of sector OAB, which is subtending, the arc is subtending an angle theta at the center, we can write as theta times r square over 2, right? Clear? All right. This theta is in radians, guys. Again, I'm telling you, this theta is in radians. We cannot use this in degrees, right? Clear? All right. I have already told you the conversion formula for angle from degree to radians and radians to degree, right? Is it clear? All right. Let's move ahead. Let's talk about some properties of the circle. Let's talk about some properties of the circle. If, let's say, this is a circle, right? And it is having some chord over here. Chord is what? Which bisects the circle at two different points. Let's name this chord as AB, right? If this is subtending some angle at center, let us call it as theta. What will be the angle subtended over here? What will be this angle? What will be the value of this angle? I hope you guys know. This angle at the boundary will be equal to what? Theta over 2, right? And if I move this particular point here on the entire blue portion which I am marking now, everywhere the angle will be same, right or not, guys? I hope you guys know this property. What I'm saying, let's look at it again, right? What I'm saying, if this is a circle and this is one of the chord, right? And this is one of the chord AB, all right? What I'm saying is that if it is subtending, this chord is some subtending some angle at the center, then all of these angles will be theta by 2, right? We know this property. All right, everywhere in this particular portion of the, in this towards the upper side of the chord, all of these angles will be equal, right? Okay, let's move on to the property number 2, right? If I'm having a circle like this, and if I draw a perpendicular, if I draw a perpendicular from the center on it, I'm having a chord, and if I draw a perpendicular from it on it from the center, this chord will be bisected, right? This chord will be bisected. Okay, so perpendicular from the center bisects the chord in a circle, right? You guys are clear with this point? Okay, number 3, that chords equidistant from the center are always equal, right? You guys know this property. What I'm saying, that if this length, right, this perpendicular length is same, right, for any chord on this circle, right? Let's say this is OA, and on this green chord, if I'm marking the perpendicular distances OM, if OA equals to OM, then this chords, right, PQ, let's name them PQ and RS, then chords PQ will be equal to RS. Length of the PQ will be equal to length of the RS, right? All right. Let's talk about something. Let's dig deeper into this. All right. If I'm having a circle and this is the center, this is some chord, right? AB. Let's name it as AB. All right, let's name the circle O. Right, if I drop a perpendicular from the center of the circle, it will bisect it, right? So both of these length will be equal, right? AM will be equal to AB. If it is subtending angle theta at the center, right, so what will be the angle AOM? Angle AOM, because OA and OB are both radiuses, right? Both radius, right? That means this is an isosceles triangle, and triangle OAB is an isosceles triangle, right? So as per the symmetry, we can say if we drop a perpendicular, that is OM, to AB, this angle AOM will be equal to angle BOM. I hope you guys have done similarity of triangles, right? By that you can definitely show it. What will be this angle equal to? That this angle will be equal to theta over 2, isn't it? Okay, let's make this triangle in detail. Let's make this triangle in detail. Why I am doing this? Because I want to calculate the area of triangle OAB, and I have been I know the area of this sector OAB already, right? I want to know the triangle of I want to know the area of triangle OAB, right? Okay, let's move ahead. This angle right over here was theta by 2. This was R, right? If I want to write the length of OB and AB, how can I write? Using trigonometry. I hope you guys are aware of this. How can we write? We can write OB over OA is equal to cos theta by 2. We can write it. Base upon hypotenuse is equals to cosine of that angle, isn't it? We can write this. Okay, OB is what we need. So we can write OB as OA into cos theta by 2. What is OA? OA is R. That is OB is equals to R times of cos theta by 2. Is it clear? Okay. Let's talk about AB. This is M over here. So, okay, AM. This is AM, right? So, and this is also OM. Oh, this is also OM. All right, now it's fine. Okay, if you want to calculate AM, AM will be what? How can we write by using this? This is, since this was 90 degree, that's why we were able to write it like this. Okay, we want to know AM. AM we can write as sine theta by 2 is equals to perpendicular, that is AM. For this triangle, if I rotate this particular triangle like this and get OM as base, then I'll be getting A as a perpendicular and this particular angle as theta by 2, isn't it? I have rotated this triangle like this so that I can write an expression between AM and OA. AM is the perpendicular and OA is the hypotenuse, right? So sine theta by 2, this angle, sine of this angle will be equal to what, guys? It will be equal to AM over OA, isn't it? AM over OA. So I can write this AM as OA into sine theta by 2, isn't it? Sine theta by 2. Achha. क्या कुछ लोग ये 2 आगे तो नहीं ले लेंगे, साइन से कॉमन तो नहीं ले लेंगे, है ना? ऐसा तो नहीं करेंगे ना? आई होप यू गाइस डोंट डू सच काइंड ऑफ सिली मिस्टेक्स. ऑलराइट, व्हाट इज ओए? ओए कितना है हमारा? आर. तो एम का लेंथ कितना हो जाएगा? आर इनटू साइन थीटा बाय 2, राइट? व्हाट वाज ओबी? देयर वाज अ रिलेशन बिटवीन एएम एंड ओबी, राइट? एबी इज ट्वाइस ऑफ एएम, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. सो व्हाट इज द लेंथ ऑफ एबी? What is the length of AB, guys? AB ka length kitna ho jayega? 2R sin theta over 2, isn't it? Now I am having AB with me. AB ka length mere paas hai, right? This length, AB ka length mere paas hai. I am also having the length of OM. OM is what? Perpendicular from the center to this chord, right? So if I want to write the area of the triangle, area of the triangle A AOB, AOB, how can write? How can I write? Half into base into height. सभी को पता है area of triangle is half into base into height. कितना लिख सकता हूँ मैं? Half into AB into OM, isn't it? Half into AB, base AB है. And what is height? Height is OM, isn't it? जो भी हमारे पास length आया, let's put it over here. AB कितना आया था? 2R sin theta by 2. 2R into sin theta by 2 multiplied by OM. What was the OM? OM was R cos theta by 2. Right? Hana? Okay. If I take this R and multiply it, what I'll get? R square and this 2. Right? Then the next expression, what will be the remaining expression? 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. I hope आप theta by 2 common नहीं ले लोगे because this is not algebra, this is trigonometry, right? These are trigonometric ratios. There is a value of this entire expression. Sin theta is having some kind of value. We cannot take 2 out of this directly, right? We have learned the formulas. If guys are watching this for the very first time, there might be some confusion, right? Okay, what is 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2? I have already told you a formula. What's that? Sin 2a, if you guys remember, what was that? 2 sin a cos a, right? You guys remember this formula? If I take a as theta over 2, what I'll get? Sin 2 into theta over 2 will be equal to 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2, right? So what will be this? Sin theta, isn't it? So I can write this entire expression as sin theta. Right or not? What will be the area of triangle AOB in that case? R square sin theta over 2. Right? If I say I need to find out the area of this particular section right over here, which I'm marking. Look at this carefully, guys. This, which I have just shaded. How will I find out the area of this region, how will I find out the area of this region? I'll subtract the area of triangle AOB from the area of the sector, circular sector AOB. If I subtract what? Area of triangle OAB from area of circular sector OAB, I'll be able to get the area of the shaded region, isn't it, guys? I'll be able to get the area of the shaded region, right? Area of the sector OAB kitna aaya tha hamare paas? Area of the sector OAB kitna aaya tha hamare paas? R square theta over 2, isn't it? R square theta over 2, considering that this is making an angle theta at the center, right? So what will be the area of that shaded region which was lying below the chord? Kitna ho jayega, considering this was theta, hai na? This region which I have already marked in the next slide as well, kitna ho jayega? Area of sector ya circular sector OAB, this was O, this was A, this was B, right? Minus area of triangle OAB, right? Area of sector OAB kitna aaya tha? R square theta over 2. This theta is in radian, guys. Alright. And this area of triangle R square sin theta by 2. So what I'll get? R square by 2 theta minus sin theta. I hope you guys are clear with this particular concept. Whenever you need to find out areas in a circle, I think now you can definitely solve for those problems, right? Isn't it easy? Okay, let's take a few example which are very easy, and I hope you guys can definitely solve that, right? Let's take this example. Find the percentage increase in, let's take A option as diagonal, and let's take B as area, right, of a square if side of square is doubled. मुझे परसेंटेज इंक्रीज निकालना है डायगनल के लेंथ के अंदर और एरिया के अंदर इफ साइड ऑफ अ स्क्वायर इज डबल. राइट, लेट्स ड्रॉ अ स्क्वायर फर्स्ट. लेट्स टेक आर इनिशियल वन वाला स्क्वायर. इट्स अ वेरी इजी प्रॉब्लम, आई होप यू गाइज नो, बट लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस सो दैट पीपल कैन रिलेट द कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट वी विल बी डूइंग इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. All right, let's take, let's say this is an area, that means all of these are sides are equal and these angles are 90 degree. Okay, what is the area of square, the earlier one square, a square? Right, now I'm having the square such that its length is doubled. It's not looking like in a square, but kindly cooperate with this square. Okay, so the length is 2a, breadth will also be equal to 2a because this is in square, right? This is a square, right? Area of this square will be what? New square will be 4a square. Let's talk about the diagonal length of this. If this is a, this is a, and this is 90 degree, diagonal kitna, diagonal ka length kitna ho jayega? Diagonal ka length kitna ho jayega? A root 2, isn't it? In this case, diagonal ka length kitna ho jayega? Diagonal will be equals to 2a into root 2, isn't it? Now, what I need to calculate? Percentage increase, right? Percentage increase ka formula kya hoga? Okay, let's write it here. Percentage increase. This the new square is having much more area as compared to the earlier one. That means we will have to find out first the difference of these two areas, and we have to divide this with the old area, right? Then we'll get the percentage increase, right? Kitna percentage increase hua as compared to the last one. So what I'll get? 4a square minus a square divided by a square into percentage. That means I have to multiply it by 100. Alright. Kitna ho jayega? 300. So 300% increase in the area. Right? Area ka problem ho gaya. What? Let's talk about diagonal. Diagonal ke andar bhi same percentage increase ka formula. Right? What will be that? 2a times root 2 minus a root 2 over a root 2 into 100, isn't it? A root 2 से a root 2 common ले लेते हैं ऊपर, कितना आ जाएगा? 2 minus 1 over a root 2 into 100, right? This will get cancelled out. What we will get? We will get 100%. So there is an 100% increase in the length of the diagonal. These concepts are very easy. I hope you guys are clear with this concepts. The concept of the circular arc will be very important for you guys. I have used the trigonometric formula as well, and also the conversion formula of the radians and degrees. I hope you guys are clear with this concept. Thank you for today's session.